To say the Outsiders and Hulk Hogan have made an impact on World Championship Wrestling, especially if you go back all the way to Memorial Day of 1996 here, and especially since the Bash at the Beach, it would be an understatement. Certainly this new world order, it cannot be sloughed off, it cannot be laughed at, it cannot be denied. It is enforcing our sport. The fact of the matter is, the way they're going about their business disturbs me, disturbs each and every wrestler in WCW. As a matter of fact, look how Steve Regal is walking to the ring with such determination on his face. It has touched each and every person, each and every man and woman in World Championship Wrestling. I'm talking about from the wrestlers to the people who work in production, in the front office. Everyone's touched by what has happened involved in this.
Yeah, and that is so true, and your statement hit it right on the head. I mean, like hitting a nail and driving it in is so true. And now then, if we start to pick up the pieces of what happened with that situation with Hulk Hogan and the Outsiders and this past Monday Night Raw, almost a hostile takeover, got very close, and they knew, like you said, our troops wasn't all in tow. Our whole team wasn't there. Bottom line, we need everybody here, and because you don't know who's going to be next, Disco Inferno could become part of the new world order. You never know. You could. I mean, I know better than that, but me saying you grew up here, sitting here together, you know, the silicone things about imagining these up the road. But things like that, stranger things that happened. Hulk Hogan, we never thought we'd see that.
Well, those Outsiders, those two men, Hall and Nash, will be a part of WCW's Hog Wild. And I know that Lex Luger thinks about what happened. He never really got his hand on those two men. But coming up at Hog Wild, he and Sting will, as that tag team match will be part of Hog Wild coming up on Saturday night, August 10th, from Sturgis, South Dakota, Dream.
Well, it just keeps getting bigger and better. WCW with a big boss play, make no mistake about it. It just happens to be that our leader, our man, we're talking about. I talk about the most powerful man in the sports industry is Hulk Hogan. Was Hulk Hogan. I'm talking about being looked up to, merchandising, athletic ability for a decade.
Had it all.
Had it all.
As the old cliche goes.
And then went ahead and got in public, if you will, and hung our laundry out on the streets in a layman's term. Well, bottom line is, we got to pick up and get after. We got to pick up and go on about our business right here at WCW with a big boss play. It will happen. Giant got to answer the call.
The Giant, will he answer the call? And fans, you can join us this Monday on Nitro to find out. The Outsiders will be at Hog Wild. Luger and Sting will be there to meet the challenge. And I can guarantee you, talking about surprises, what surprises are in store this Monday on Nitro? Will there be yet another man to join this new world order? And if so, who will he be? Will it happen Monday? Will it happen in Hog Wild? Fans, only thing I can tell you is you can't miss a minute of World Championship Wrestling, starting with the pro Saturday morning, Saturday night, Sunday night, Nitro, and of course, worldwide. Wow. And pro, syndicated all over the world. Oh, an elbow on top of the head.
Yeah, just going in front of here, trying to get a little momentum going his way, really. Really cranking up here with Lars Steven Regal, and now he's booty dancing just a little bit with him big elbow.
So the Disco Inferno, ever since his match with Dean Malenko recently at Bash at the Beach, and really stepped it up a notch.
Yeah, a little more focused, but still needs to be more focused.
A lot more.
And you know, I got our Harley and everything trying to get a sidecar to drive you into town and put you in the sidecar, because I have asked the booty babe to put on some skimpy and ride with you in Sturgis downtown, and me and my Harley, you in the sidecar, so everybody don't beat you up when they see you ain't got no woman with you. You know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
And she be looking good. And I say, wear something skimpy, because we won't put it on the air. Wear something Sturgis. And we're talking Hog Wild, brother.
Speaking of Hog Wild, would you take a look at Lord Steven Regal?
He's Hog Wild.
My goodness, look at the velocity of those blows. And both knees went up to the forehead that time.
Caught him too right there, the bridge of the nose more than the forehead. That'll cross your eyes, really make your eyes water. You know?
Absolutely. Well, the intensity of Lord Steven Regal, I can only think it's because what has gone down over the past couple of weeks here at World Championship Wrestling, especially since Bash at the Beach back on the 7th of July.
You know, Regal coming into a situation here where everything's not real well in his camp. When we talk about the different camps,
right.
You know, Bobby Duke Earl ain't getting along with them at all.
1-2, Disco. As his man too close to the ropes at time, Regal.
The husband got the young guns running rum child with Mongo and Chris Benoit. The Dungeon of Doom always looking for new moves. And then the NWO, the New World Order, saying we will take over WCW with a big ball play. Ha! Shame on you. Shame on you, boy.
Stomping on the back of the head, Lord Steven Regal. Well, I can tell you right now, this new world order headed by the Outsiders, headed by Hulk Hogan, certainly
at his post.
Certainly an organization that has to be dealt with, an order that has to be concerned with. But I believe, and I'm seeing right here, Lord Steven Regal, as intense as we've ever seen him. I think the wrestlers and the athletes in WCW have stepped it up a notch. I know we have. And I tell you, WCW is together like never before.
Yeah, Tony, that's true. But I got a problem with that statement in a little bit. Everybody's stepping it up a notch. But stepping it up for who? Stepping it up for the New World Order or stepping it up for WCW? What are they actually doing? Now he's a dealing on him right there. Got that double shot, boogaloo. Getting down and right with Lord Steven Regal.
Up and down. The Disco Inferno.
Well, what was he trying to do there?
I don't know if he was trying to dance.
Well, whatever he was doing, he got into it real quick.
He got butterflied, didn't he?
Yes, he sure did.
And whoa! Right in the nose! That was a soccer goal.
And he got him right in the nose in the old Snazola.
He kicked him in the face and the disco.
He kicked him in the nose.
I told you. And that's on the face the last time I checked. And here's a cover. One, two, three. Disco's not going to get up from that.
His ain't on his face anymore.
No,
on the side of his head.
Holy Moses, I mean.
Me.
Look at the luck of Lord Steven Regal. The termination in British nobility like we've never seen before in the sport since his arrival here a few years ago.
He turned it on. Yes, he did.
He really did. And we're going to send him over to talk. We're going to check his teeth there. Send him over to talk to Lee Marshall here on WCW Saturday night. Nope, nose and teeth, and they are a part of the face as well.
Oh, stop
all right.
It. Stop it. You're killing me.
Here you go again.
All right, got him a double underarm hook up here. You what you call a butterfly. I don't know where you got that from. And then he went ahead and got him in a position to get to the pay window right away. And we're talking about a very intense loss, Steven Regal.
Regal is your winner, standing by now with Lee Marshall.
Thank you very much, Tony. As a matter of fact, Lord Steven Regal, let me reflect on something that Tony Schiavone said to Dusty Rhodes, and that is, since this entire New World Order business started happening, nobody has become more intense, determined than you.
These people want to eat into my television time, time when I can be doing what I do best in the ring. Well, I may at times be a dirty, rotten scoundrel. I may at times do things that you peasants don't like. But one thing I am is very loyal to my country and loyal to the people that are loyal to me. Now, Hulk Hogan has decided to tear the hearts out of millions of little children and families around the world that stood by every word he said. I wouldn't do that for anything in the world, for all the teen shiners, we English say. You are a traitor. You should be hung for the crimes that you have committed against your people.
Before I let you go, Lord Steven Regal, let me ask you as well about Eddie Guerrero.
I know about Eddie Guerrero. I know what I'm saying. Mr. Guerrero, I take pride in humiliating the people that I think are considered special by these peasants that are watching right now. You are one of them. I am going to humiliate you. After the embarrassment of getting beaten by you a few weeks ago, I am going to degrade you. I am going to bring you down to earth. And in a bad, bad way, Sunshine.
Lord Steven Regal, I guarantee you, Eddie Guerrero is going to have something to say about that. Don't go away. We continue on Saturday night.